Have all three names now of the men killed by a suicide bomber. They are Sean Hannon, Jeffrey Rick, and Captain Nick Rozanski.
The river flows, it flows to the sea. Wherever that river goes, that's where I want to be.
It's imperative that we ride single file. We've got a few officers with us today on motorcycles that are going to be shutting down the ramps as we go along. They have to hold that ramp closure until the last bike in the motorcade passes. Then they have to come back around, get back up front in time to catch the next one. So to do that, with the motorcade running about probably 45, 50 mile an hour, those bikes are going to be traveling 110 mile an hour or so to get back up front. But other than that, we'll be going here shortly, and have a good ride.
Here we've got General Harris, who is the Assistant Adjutant General for the Army National Guard here in Ohio. Thank you for coming, sir. Today we're gathered here at this memorial site to remember that we are one nation with one flag. The freedoms we enjoy as Americans today have not come without a price. The markers here at this memorial represent the heroic men and women from the great state of Ohio who gave their lives in the global war on terror so that we can live in freedom and without fear. On April 4th, 2012, Captain Nick Rozanski, Master Sergeant Sean Hannon, and Master Sergeant Jeffrey Rick, all Ohio National Guardsmen and residents of the Columbus area, were killed in action in the city of Maimana, Afghanistan, during operations in support of Operation Enduring Freedom. We are here today so that the memory of their sacrifice, as well as that of their families, is not forgotten. We're also here to celebrate their willingness to make the ultimate sacrifice for their country. The Nick Rozanski Memorial Foundation was established to benefit students and families within the local Dublin community through scholarships and other charitable foundations. The scholarship will enable future generations of young, courageous men and women like Nick Rozanski to follow their dreams. The foundation will provide Nick's family a way to touch the lives of others year after year in honor of their husband and father, and will serve as a way to give back to the community that Nick was such a big part of and had given so much to him. The United States has always been the first nation to stand up and fight for the freedom of people from around the world. Many of you here today are veterans of wars and conflicts that America has had to fight to protect the innocent and oppressed. You answered that call and served your country well. We are here to say thank you, and we are honored to know you. There are many men and women serving right now in all branches of the military, here at home and in places far away that most of us have never heard of. These men and women are part of the best trained, best equipped force in the world. We honor them and their families for the sacrifices they make each day to keep our country safe from terrorism, hatred, and injustice that plagues the world today. When you see a veteran or a serving member of the armed forces, take a moment to say thank you. We owe them our way of life, and a moment of your time thanking them is time well spent. Honor Guard.
Attention.